A speech on the House floor in June this summer, Democratic Congresswoman Susan Wild of Pennsylvania shared the very personal story of her life's partner suicide earlier this year. Let's watch her on the floor of the House.
As some are aware, today marks the one-month anniversary of the death of my beloved life partner, Carrie Acker. What most people don't know is that Carrie's death was a suicide. Why am I sharing this very personal story? Because we all need to recognize that mental health issues know no boundaries. I do not want anyone else to suffer as he suffered, nor for any family to suffer as mine has over the past month. This is a national emergency. Every community in our country has been touched in some way by major mental health challenges. Removing the stigma cannot just be a slogan. We need to make it real through our actions.
Well, as the Washington Post noted in an interview with Congresswoman Wild, quote, the video went viral and prompted an outpouring of people thanking her for sharing her story. Well, Congresswoman Susan Wild joins me right now during National Suicide Prevention Month, which we're in right now, to discuss the legislation she's planning to introduce on Friday to raise awareness about suicide and reduce the stigma around mental health. Thank you so much. So I guess big question, what took you to the House floor to talk about such a personal loss?
Well, it was a month after it happened. It was the hardest thing I've ever gone through in my life. Heartbreaking, it still is. And I just felt as though some kind of something constructive had to come out of it, and that we had to elevate this discussion, not just about mental health, but about all of the causes of suicide. Sometimes it's chronic pain, as it was in his case. Sometimes it is a quick something that happens in somebody's life.
Yes, and that's what we hear.
Yes, I mean, somebody's spouse asks for a divorce, and I've spoken with people who were in exactly that kind of situation. But for me, it was just really important that I use my public platform to try to shed some light on this.
Well, let's talk about this, because is there something can be done by government to help people who are in distress, who are feeling serious chronic depression, and are ready to do something like your partner did?
I believe that there is something that can be done by government, and I also believe that there's something that can be done by all of us. As far as the government's role in it, it is to support and give the resources necessary for communities and families and people to fight this illness and this epidemic. And, you know, we can do things as simple as a bill that's currently pending that I've co-sponsored, a three-digit number for a suicide hotline as opposed to the
there
long...
There isn't one now.
Well, no three-digit number. There's a long 10-digit number that I can't even remember as I sit here now. So I think that's a really simple fix.
What happens when you have a person like Alcoholics Anonymous has a program where if you're about to go drink and you shouldn't, because you know it's going to take you back to where you shouldn't be, you call up somebody. Mm-hmm. You know, what would be that appropriate situation for a person feeling really serious chronic depression?
Well, you know, the problem is that we don't talk about chronic depression. Alcoholics Anonymous has done a terrific job over the years in dealing with alcoholism. We don't have anything similar for people who are suffering from terrible depression, which is brought on by all different kinds of things. The truth of the matter is that we try to depress the subject. One of the things that I always say to people is, imagine if you were seriously depressed, and would you go to your employer to tell him or her that you were seriously depressed and needed treatment? Probably not. If you were diagnosed with cancer and you needed treatment and you needed time off from work to go for your chemo treatments or whatever, you would absolutely go talk to your employer.
How do we change that?
How do we change that?
But you're on Friday, you're going to declare your announcement of your program. How does that deal with that?
We talk about it, we elevate it, we make people realize that there are people all over the country who are dealing with this. We know that 47,000 people committed suicide in 2017. We know, this is surprising, that the highest rate of suicide recently has been white men over 60, which includes my beloved partner. And, you know, so this is a problem that has no boundaries. We have to be much more open about it. We've accomplished a lot in the world of mental health, but not on this issue.
Tell me what kind of reaction you got when you went on the floor of the House this summer.
You know, Chris, when I went on the floor of the House, I really did it more as a way of communicating.
What kind of reaction you get?
My colleagues were so wonderful and there for me right after. But the more importantly, afterwards, I started hearing from people all over the country, including a former NFL player who is going to appear on Friday at a roundtable that we're hosting on this very subject. I heard from people all over the country about their own experience, family members. Mm-hmm. I heard from an official in my district whose mother committed suicide when he was very young and he had never told anybody about it. People have been coming out of the woodwork. I talked to at least three people a day who have been affected.
Remember Richard
this.
Corey, the poem?
Mm-hmm.
We all grew up with it. The guy who had it made,
yes,
took his life. Richard, yeah, Corey, what a poem, yeah, that was.
We've got to stop this.
Congressman Susan Wild of Pennsylvania, especially from the Allentown area. By the way, we'll have to have you on a brighter subject, how Pennsylvania's going to go next year, because you are from the swing district, I've always been told.
Watch. Can we end on a positive note?
Sure.
My dog Zoe was voted the cutest dog on Capitol Hill just this evening before I came over here.
And my heart is full.
There,
okay,
you go.
Thank you. I'm glad you did that. On a more happy note, anyway, thank you so much. If you are having suicidal thoughts, back to the serious, or if you are worried about anyone you think does, there is help available. The National Suicide Prevention Lifeline. Now, this is a long number, but it's a 1-800. You can remember that. As you start with 1-800. Then you have to go to 273-TALK. That's pretty good. 273-TALK. That's 1-800-273-8255. 273-TALK. Pretty easy to remember. 800 that.